Hey guys, today I would like to show you another interesting way to create chords inside Bitwig, because unusual paths often lead to interesting results. So let's start. All we need is one instrument track and one multi-note device and one diatonic transposer. And first of all, we set our desired scale and mode, and this is C and minor. And we also make sure that we have the constrain option enabled. And to hear a sound, we use a polysynth as an instrument. We reset the multi-note device and leave the first option or the first note with zero pitch, so nothing changes. C goes in, C goes out. Next, we use a second note, four semitone steps above the root note, and one seventh semitone steps above the root note. And this is a major chord. If we now press the C note on the keyboard, we create a C major chord. But since our diatonic transposer is set for C minor and a C major chord is not part of the C minor scale, the chord will be corrected accordingly. So it results in a C minor chord. C major and corrected C minor. You can now use all notes on the keyboard and always create the appropriate chord for the selected scale. So far, nothing special yet, and this is pretty much the easiest way to create harmonies. So you always stay in key. I've also done this in my last EDM tutorial before, and of course, using standard chords from the scale is a bit boring in the long run, so let's change that. We now set the major fourth to 1 and the major seventh to 2. And we add an expression modulator. With the velocity, we now modulate the second note with the value 3. And the third note with the value 5. We can now control how far apart the notes from the chord are from each other, and we can create a standard chord if we use the maximum velocity value, because 1 plus 3 is 4 and 2 plus 5 is 7. And every other velocity value in between means some different chord, but the chord is corrected by the diatonic transposer afterwards. So let's try this. So let's create a clip. And now we can start to draw our notes and modify our chord with the velocity. That's okay. Now we can add some kind of bass. Two octaves below. Now let's add some reverb. Create a group with the polysynth, so we have so we can use another polysynth, and then maybe make a lead sound or a plug sound with an arpeggiator, maybe, I don't know. And now you can easily edit and modify your chords. You can now even hear the chords playing while you are dragging the velocity sliders, and it's pretty easy to edit chords. Of course, you can add more modulations and maybe some complexer stuff. But this is just an introduction, so see it as a starting point. There are so many more possibilities to create chords inside Bitwig, and this is one of them. So let's try and recap this tutorial. First, we created one multi-note device, which creates some kind of chord. Then we modulated each note inside this chord with the velocity value, which results in a very unusual chord with velocity zero. And a very standard chord with the maximum value, which of course sounds very resolving because it's a standard chord. Then we corrected each of these notes into our selected scale. In this case, it's C minor, so we have always correct notes. And then we feed these notes inside this container, which contains two polysynths, and these instruments are playing our notes. So it's pretty easy to create chords now with one note and the velocity values. So we have easy living. And that's it for this tutorial. So thanks for watching. Please leave me a like, subscribe to the channel, and many, many thanks to my current Patreons for supporting me. Thank you. Until next time, bye.